to the internet and start timing. Okay. 3, 2, 1, go. All right, this engine and transmission combination here weighs about 385 pounds. Takes four guys to pick it up and move it like they're doing. This is a 1926, we think. We're not really sure. Everything was donated. There is no serial number on the motor. So we don't know where it came from. A lot of pieces and parts. This entire car was donated part by part from members of the club. Our club has about 60 family members. And between the 60 members, we have about 85 Model Ts. Some own more than one, as you can tell. Most of us just have one. There's a couple that don't have any. Here's one right here, doesn't have a Model T, but we're working on it. We're going to get him out there. We've been doing this again for about 45 years. Every time we do it, the team is different. You also hear some fallacies about the Model T. One is that the Model T will climb a hill in the low gear. You have to turn around and back it up. That's not quite true. The reason they back them up the hill is because we don't have a fuel pump. And the gas tank sits underneath the seat, which is actually a little above the carburetor. So when you go up a hill, the carburetor gets to the point where it's the same level as the gas tank and you have no gas flow. So if you turn around and back it up the hill, the reverse gear is the same as the low gear. You back it up the hill so that the gas tank stays above the carburetor. One of the other myths that you hear about a Model T is get it in any color as long as it is
black.
Right. Well, that's not quite true either. When Model T's first started coming out in 1909 through 1913, they came out in four different colors. And because of the assembly line, which Ford has been given credit for inventing, that's not true either, you couldn't get the paint to dry fast enough. Found a paint called Japan Black. They could paint these things and get them off the assembly line in about 1 minute to keep up with production. The guys have put the wishbone under it now. We've got the front wheels on it. The engine is in place. Now we're going to put the rear end under it and hook up the universal joint. Just hooking up the universal joint can get very tedious sometimes trying to get it lined up properly. There are a few clubs around the nation that have these Model T take-apart cars. A lot of them are just a chassis like you see right now. Others are like ours that have bodies on them. We do not know exactly how many there are around the country. We know that West Virginia had one a few years ago. We're the only one in this general vicinity that has one. I'm talking D.C., Maryland, Virginia, Delaware, so on and so forth. Credit for the assembly line. Actually, it was a guy named Ransom B. Olds, inventor of the Oldsmobile. He used a boat to pull his turf and actually through an assembly line process. He really invented the scene. Ford perfected it. Like I said, Ford was getting the Model T off every minute. A little over 15 million Model Ts made from 1909 to 1927. Right? And they converted over to the Model A. Also in 26 and 27, they offered colors again. 1917, Model T touring car sold for about $325. And by 1924, you could buy a Roadster, which is basically what this one is. This one has a pickup body on it. You could buy a Roadster for about $260. Still a lot of money, but still very cheap. Ford said one of the best things about a Model T is it didn't heat. This is a good shit banger because of the running board struts that come out. Model T engine is a 20 horsepower, 177 cubic inch engine. You have a good downhill run with a tailwind, you can probably get 45 miles per hour out of one. However, the Chevy sedan is not one of the. Drive a Model T with the three pedals on the transmission, on top of the transmission. Our left one is for low and high gear associated along with the brake rod. The middle pedal is reverse and the far pedal is the brake, which is not a wheel brake, it's a transmission brake. Model T'ers kind of refer to this braking system as an ABS system, almost a braking system. You ever try to stop one of these things, every stop is a panic stop. Don't ever want to walk out in front of a Model T. Guarantee you, it can't stop. How are we doing on time there, young lady? 7.5 minutes. Doing good. Earlier I said that the Model T gas tank was under the seat. Caused a problem when you were going up the hill. The driver probably had referred to the mountains or the hills as a 2-gallon hill or a 3-gallon hill. He had to have at least that much gas in the tank for the Model T. 1926, Ford changed and put the gas tank in the hill. See, ours has a gas tank up on the cow. That eliminated the problem of going up the hill and finding out gas. This gas tank now sitting on top of the carburetor, or very close to on top of the carburetor. But you always have gravity and flow. Model T also did not have a water pump. Yes, a thermal siphon system. When the water got hot, it started to flow. From the engine into the top of the radiator down and circulated. Model T's came in a bunch of different body styles. Roadster pickups, which is what this one is. You had hardtop coupes, large KT trucks. If you've been up on the hill, you'll find a recent barn. KT truck. Sitting in a barn, we don't know how many years. It happens to belong to Tony Offerman. He's still trying to figure out how many years it's been in that barn, and where the title is. Oh, you got the title now? It was in the barn 61 years. Just pulled that one out of the barn and got it running. We have another Model T on the road. Yeah. LTs were sold as a bare chassis, meaning you had the engine and the wheels and the seat and the steering wheel. The body was left up to you. I myself have a 1919 Model T Depot Hack wheel. It was sent to Pennsylvania as a chassis only, sent to a body shop or a cabinet maker in York, Pennsylvania. He built the body for it. The body is known as a York body. Somewhere around 1926, Ford started making their own Depot Hack bodies. Depot Hack is basically used as a taxi cab from train depots to hotels. Basically the first taxi. We're getting close here now. Got some fenders on. Water in the radiator. I see the driver coming in. I guess they think it's more of a front run. We have to wait and see.
Look how the missile light is.
Uh-oh, we opened the door. I guess that means somebody's going to find me there. Notice all of these Model T's have a pot. This is a power pot.
I'm going to go out. I'm going to go out. I'm going to go out.